I don't know about you, but that's what I've been doing. That's what I've been doing lately, ever since a season of thanksgiving has been declared upon us. Ever since, hallelujah, a season of paying our vow back to God have been declaring over us. I've been counting, and I've been giving. I know that you all doing that, but we've been giving God the name that is due to His name, according to the experience that we have experienced Him. Hallelujah. So there was this old African song that I have been singing. Amen. All of the other gods, they are the works of men. But you are the most high God. There is none like you. All of the other gods, they are the works of men. But you are the most high God. The God we worship. There is none like you, Jehovah. You are the most high. You are the most high God, Jehovah. You are the most high. You are the most high God, Jehovah. You are the most high. You are the most high God. All of the other gods, but they are the works of men. You are the most high God. There is none like you, Jehovah Nissi. You are the most high. You are the most high God, Jehovah Nissi. You are the most high. You are the most high God, Jehovah Rapha. You are the most high. You are the most high God, Jehovah Shalom. If He's been your peace, you are the most high God, my Jesus. You are the most high. You are the most high God. If He comforted you, Mount Carmel, you are the most high. You are the most high God. Wow, my Jesus, you are the most high. You are the most high God. Hallelujah, there is none like Him. We worship the most high God. We gather to worship and bring Him the glory that is due to Him. The God who is revealed to us. The God who showed Himself to us in such a mighty way. Hallelujah, we don't just come to give thanks to a God, hallelujah, a memorial serve of a God who is dead. But we come to celebrate a living God. He's the God of today. He's the God of yesterday. He's the God of yesterday. Today, oh, Lavakashanda Lavasia Lavando. It is this God that we worship. It is this God that we have to break out in praise. Hallelujah. That's what's in my heart. And wow, what an awesome worship time. I wanted to go on and on and on and on. I must say, I wanted to swim in that river. Basically, that was our sermon. Because there's nothing else we're going to say but the Thanksgiving season. Hallelujah. It's upon us. He is worthy to be praised. Amen. In and out of season, we praise Him. Amen. Even there might be few things there and there that look like a mountain. But let me tell you one thing. Once you start praising the Almighty, once you stand on His faithfulness and worship Him and glorify Him, believe me, all the mountains are like a mole. Oh, I was remembering a story an awesome man of God told me. He said he was taking his daughter, which she was the age of Malay and Lydia Ephraim. They don't pronounce very well the vowels. And he said when we took off the plane, she said she looked down and she said, Daddy, little people, little cars, little tree, little buildings, little but big sun, she kept saying. And he tried to explain to her to change her mind. No. This is whenever we take off from situation, the gravity. He said to her that, but these are big people, big house, big. But she said, no, Daddy, they're little people. Little house, little. What's the point of this story today? But once we start raising, hallelujah, with our praise, once we start going up, hallelujah, we mount up with wings like eagle. Amen. And we start to see things like an eagle see. Little problem, little mountain, little hiccup, little. rise up. Hallelujah. Let's take off with that plane that never reverses. And let us approach this awesome and mighty God. The closer we got to God, hallelujah, the smaller our storm gets. You know what they say? You hear this. It may be cliche, but it's so true. He said that don't tell God how big your storm is, but tell God, tell the storm how big your God is. You can only do that, hallelujah. Oh, if we're connected and day in and day out, and it's been quite a blessing, hallelujah. Sunday after Sunday, His blessing is upon us, hallelujah. You know, when our pastor, awesome pastor, declared Thanksgiving season, I say, God, wow, amen to that. We've been doing it all along, but it's not like, okay, we gotta wait, let's complain for 8 months, and you know, but no, we've been doing it. But we take a point mindfully to praise the God that we serve, the God who called us, the God who knows us by name. Amen. Not by my last name, but by my name. Hallelujah. So I'm with you. I'm just saying I'm with you to praising Him. Amen. This brings me to my word, which is no other word, but that's the word that I heard I was asked to preach today. It's the mighty one has done a great thing. Yes. Holy is His name. Amen. Amen. The mighty one has done a great thing. Holy is His name. Amen. Hallelujah. Et hayyal abi gabri gabarna sumu qudus yu. Amen. Holy is His name. He has done great thing. Who? The mighty one. Amen. Taking a time and a moment of wondering, what is this great thing He has done? Because that is somebody else's song. I have to make it my own. Amen. It's someone who had really gotten out with God and say, the mighty one has done great thing. Holy is His name. Amen. That's why it's just an opportunity to take some inventory and count them all, because it's easy to forget. Amen. Yes. The mighty one has done great thing. Holy is His name. Amen? Amen. In your life individually, in your life, hallelujah, in our life corporately, yes, as a church, as a ministry, yes, the mighty one has done a great thing. Yes. Holy is His name. Amen. Amen. I want to talk about this God who, hallelujah, when we look back, me and you have a lot of bad God testimony. If it had not been for God testimony, we look back, how did I make it? How did I make it? It can be normal because you toughen up yourself and you go through it. But when you look back and calculate where He has brought us from, you can't help but say, the mighty one has done a great thing, and holy is His name. He always leads us in triumph. Amen? You know, the people, men and women of God, in the Bible, they are written for our teachings. Yes. I think Eden touched on that. But when I thought of people that paid attention to what God did. Yes. You know, Moses is not a likely person that I would think or imagine, even from growing up, or a white bird with a stick, man, as a praise dancer. Amen? Praise worshiper. I don't have that. But he wrote the mighty, awesome, the most exuberant worship, praise unto God.
Amen.
Where? Not when they entered to the promised land, but they were on the other side of the Red Sea. Amen? To give you a background, but this is what he said. I will sing to the Lord. He has triumphed gloriously.
Amen.
The horse and the rider has... I think I'm okay. Sure, why not? The horse and its rider He has hurled unto the sea. Amen?
Amen.
He looked at what God has done. I'm not going to talk about Exodus. For those of you that don't know the story, it's on Exodus chapter 13, 14, 15.
Yes.
But just in a nutshell, He let them go, let my people go. So He let them go. The Pharaoh and Egypt let the Israelites go from slavery. 400-year slavery, He let them go. And here they are in the front of the Red Sea, two mountains by their side, right and left, and at their back, charging Pharaoh. You know the story. But charging Pharaoh, they're so terrified. So Moses lifts up his hand. And God say, be still and see the salvation of the Lord. Amen. And you know what? The mighty one has done great things. Holy is his name. He opened the Red Sea. And through dry land, they cross over. Amen. The enemy came charging, thinking, I got them. I can't just let them go.
Yes.
And you know what? They were swallowed. Amen? The enemy was swallowed. Amen?
Hallelujah.
The chariot and horse and Pharaoh and his riders were swallowed by the sea. How did he do it? The Lord we serve just blew a wind over the water.
Hallelujah.
And when the Egyptians get to the middle, and they were swallowed by the water.
Yes.
You know, what does it mean to our life, Johannes? Pharaoh of our generation, the enemy, the world, things that don't want to let us go,
yes,
things that want to hold us back,
yes,
from our destiny, things,
yes,
that came after us, charging,
yes,
this is it for you.
Amen.
This is your year.
Woo!
You're not going to see 2017.
Yeah.
I will do everything I can with all my might to stop this, to stop from what God's plan is for you to happen. He came charging. Guess what? Our God, who is mighty to save, has saved us. Amen? He has delivered us. Amen? Oh, the God we serve is a deliverer. Amen? So just like Moses, hallelujah, even, I don't know, we have to break with songs like, I believe if Moses was Ethiopian, he would say, Mentesenot, 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 Yeferuon in Sarawit, Mentesenot, Aderego Yewaharat, Mentesenot, El Shaddai Amlak Newena, Emisano Yelemena, Mentesenot in Nibelo, Dilien Migenyo, Yanibelo, El Shaddai Amlak Newena, Emisano Yelemena, Mentesenot in Nibelo, Dilien Migenyo, Yanibelo, Yeferon in Sarawit, Aderego Yewaharat,
Mentesenot.
For those of you who don't understand, the Amharic, it means the captains, the war, the men of war of Pharaoh,
yes,
he has made them,
yes,
to nothing.
Amen.
He is able to take us. Amen. Thank you, Ellen.
Amen.
I hardly mean this, but it's good.
Amen.
God is so good.
Amen.
We are to break out in praise. Amen.
Amen.
Not only read about him, if you read it, you will see, oh God, he says, your right hand, oh God, has become glorious in power. Amen? And you know, he concludes saying, you are fearful in praise. None like you. Amen? You know, we can sing his song, but we can make it our own. There's an invitation. Amen? The next couple months, we just got to tune in and just see. Let's see Pharaoh.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let's break out in praise. Hallelujah. As they did, they only sang, the men and women of God, they only sang after a victory, after a provision. Amen. That's why I was calling him earlier, Jehovah Shalom, if he has been your peace. Amen. Whatever that God has been to you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I just want to stir myself up. I'm stirring myself up.
Amen.
I want to stir each other up to praise him, the glory that is due to his name.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, we don't praise a God we don't pray to.
Yes.
What do I mean by that?
Yes.
you know me, I love praise. I love to worship God because he has done so much for me.
Amen.
And there was a brother always came to me on a gathering, and he would say at the end, you know, Brother Johannes, in 1900s, there was a prophecy that came out, people will put more emphasis in praise than prayer. But I say, my brother, but what you don't know is, we don't praise the God we don't pray to. Amen? We don't praise the God we don't pray to for positive doing, to feel positive. We don't ignore him the whole 7 days, and we come here to praise him.
Yeah.
We praise the God we pray to, we cry to, hallelujah, and we see him answer prayers. Amen? That's the God I want to talk about. I'm talking to those who are standing on his faithfulness, and they can truly say, I prayed to God and he truly saw me. I am telling you, when I look of all those characters in the Bible, I fell in love with Hannah.
Amen.
Hannah in chapter 1, chapter 2, 1 Samuel.
Yes.
Woman of God, Hannah,
yes,
is someone who concluded so strong.
Yes.
She fulfilled her vow.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
She is someone that did the process right, and she concluded to God, whatever, she fulfilled her vow. She brought her praise. She is one mighty woman who broke out in praise. Amen. It will be so nothing. It will benefit us nothing if I just tell you about her. But you know, this woman understood what it meant to call upon God.
Yes.
Understood. Let me give you a little background.
Amen.
Because we all relate to her brokenness. Amen?
Amen.
A woman who got married with hopes to have a child, to have a good marriage, to be blessed.
Yes.
She had dreams about her marriage.
Yes.
But you know what? Lo and behold, God closed her womb. She didn't have a child.
Yes.
She had a brokenness. She had emptiness.
Yes.
She had stress.
Yes.
She was despised. She was looked down upon. She was so empty. She was distressed. She was miserable. A woman of anguish.
Yes.
She had a heartbrokenness that we could all relate to.
Yes, yes, yes.
You know, so she had this. But this thing, you know, it didn't take her out of the plan of God.
Amen.
Even, you know, when you read, when you go back and read, you will see she had a very supportive husband.
Amen.
He was a very supportive husband. Even in our days today, if a woman don't have a child, you know, no many supportive, but hers was supportive. He loved her, the Bible says, specifically. I don't want to talk about him, but about Hannah, she wouldn't take a soother.
Yes,
you know, when he give kids a soother to calm them down, she wouldn't take, no. She said, Badon not watch a hobat. Remember that song, Kasu? Badon nete esich ohobin. Her emptiness was so loud within her, she couldn't sleep. She couldn't even ignore it. Her emptiness, day in and day out, she lays her head. It's there. She can't ignore it. Her husband is comforting her. It's there. So she knows that this emptiness, this void, this heartbrokenness, would not be taken care of by another man. Amen?
Amen.
You know, the Lord, hallelujah, He is mighty. He has done great things, even by creating that dissatisfaction.
Amen.
Even dissatisfaction is from the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
To do and to will. She could have been satisfied. Oh, who cares? If he's not mad, I'll just, you know. But she refused.
Amen.
You know, she refused. She said, only the hand of God.
Amen.
So she said, I got a business to take care of. So with her, we all, there has been a place where things try to comfort us. Things to say, it's okay so and so. It's okay, Johannes. Everything is going to be okay. Look at the next guys. They're worse. They have it worse. You know, we're here to support you. There are many things.
Yeah.
But, you know, still it didn't satisfy us.
Yes.
People's counseling did not really soothe it. Did not do it for us. Amen?
Yes.
A lot of you experienced that.
Amen.
Where you run to the house of God.
Yes.
Where your brokenness could not be met. But only the touch of the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
I got to witness that. I got to witness people running in their brokenness to the house of the Lord.
Amen.
We can all share with her brokenness.
Yes.
Amen? She ran. And you know, she, you know, it's amazing. She got in this little room. She's crying out to God. She's praying. She's praying. Oh, you know, but not even a sound is heard. No, you know, it was so loud though. It was so loud enough that God heard it in the middle of that beautiful worship that happens in heaven. Holy, holy, holy. A lot is happening there. A lot of, you know, glorious thing is happening here. But here is God hearing, fulfilling His word. His ear was hearkened to her. Amen?
Amen.
He heard her in that little room.
Yes.
Even the priest didn't even know she was there. But the Lord said, shh, my daughter. I'm paraphrasing.
Yes.
You know, you're not going to fight. But you know what? As it's true, the Bible says the poor man cried out to God and He hearkened him.
Amen?
Amen. He heard His voice. Amen? Zembel alalat.
Amen.
Hanan, Exiambir, Zembel, Aralat. Amen. And Noho, Kasamayat, Bela, Yalo, Samat, Lizunquan, Altachala, Tommy, Milmas Murala. You know, basically what he says, you look down in the heavens and in the earth. God is not just looking down to the earth, also the heavens. He's also above the heaven. Amen. And you know, if you go to the third, He's above that. Even the heavens could not contain Him. He is a sovereign God, but He is so intimate. Amen? How many of us run to the house of God because of situation? I don't know what to do, but I'm going to go. I'm going to run to the house of the Lord. I'm going to hasten to the throne of God and call upon Jesus.
Amen.
How many of us did that? Like nothing will comfort us. That dissatisfaction. God got us on our knees. I'm not even talking about 2 years ago. I'm not talking about 3 years ago. This year alone.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. This year alone, you know, then we say, well, I got nothing to do. I got to come to the house of the Lord.
Amen.
And you know what? God in his might, God heard us. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God answered us. God healed us. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God heard our prayer. God paid attention. Hallelujah. God paid attention. Hallelujah. He met us in this place. Hallelujah. He met us. Hallelujah. Whatever you cried out to God, it's been heard, and it's him from above hearing. Hallelujah. That brought, hallelujah, satisfaction.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. How many experienced the emptiness she experienced? Hallelujah. God heard and answered us. Amen. He replied us. Amen. The mighty God, the awesome God, sovereign, but yet he was intimate in your life. Amen. He was intimate. You know, this big God, who am I? Who are we? You know? Some of us, one day, barakhayna halifna. Amen. You know, Ruta Mokriya, Zamrata Mazmurala, my favorite. And the reason for that is because she told me the testimony of it too. That song was given to her. You know, it was a time where it was impossible for her to lift up her head. I got to talk to her about something, so she gave me like an hour testimony on it. She said, you know, they went to put city together in Ethiopia, and her husband car accident on a mission field, passed away. She came, she withhold that city. She withhold that city, and we're like, oh man, she was like world popular. Like, what is she going to do? It was brokenness. But she came with this city. You know, ready kani. Amen. Ready kani mesong all of kesek labrubel.
Amen.
She got the idea from Psalm where the singers of Zion, you know them, the singers of Zion when they were under captivity. Captivity in the days of Babylon. They were in captivity by the river of Babylon. They said they hung their harp on the willow. They hung their singing. They suspended their praise. What am I talking about this? Because, but God helped me and you not to hang our harp in the willow. Amen? Not to hang, hallelujah, not to suspend our praise. Not to say, oh God, not today. Let this year be, I'll come to the house of God. But let me just say, let me be a little bit sad. Let me mourn a little bit. 2017 is going to be a place of praise.
Amen.
You know, we, in order not to do that within a week, within a 2 week, hallelujah, he gave us our heart back.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. You know, just like with Hannah, the Bible says God answered her. He answered her and she was no longer sad.
Amen.
She was no longer sad. She vowed. She was a woman of business. She said, if you give me, I vow to give back to you. Amen.
Amen.
She said that. And you know what? Her face was no longer sad. Eli came and accused her. You're just drunk. She said, no, I'm just full of anguish. Because she was praying really low. And some people out of that prayer, they said, you know what? God heard Hannah. Why do you have to be loud, Yohannes? They say that they used it. You know, you heard their word. It's actually, you know. Yeah, you know what, my brother? I heard it from somebody, but I see, you know, these people that like to pray slow, and that there's people that are radical like me.
Yeah.
So they were getting together to pray for their city. So the people that like this, Baptist, they said, brother, God can hear us. You know, we don't have to, you know, to disturb him. The Pentecostal say, he's not nervous either. So on whatever level, on whatever way you cried out to God, whether you say, Jesus, or you say, Jesus, or you just came, nobody see you at the back, just He heard you. He heard the loud. And hallelujah. God hears us. Amen. He is not a respecter of person. He is not man that he shall lie. I mean, he comes through. He came. She was no longer sad. Amen. Still, the mighty one has done a great thing. Holy is his name.
Amen.
Even to bring us to our knees.
Amen.
To take away our sadness.
Amen.
Remember we sang, he took away my ashes. He gave me beauty. Amen. Yemogos Memphis. When the name to he gave me beauty for ashes. Hallelujah. A garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. How could we be silent? He is a mighty one. He has done a great thing. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
She wept in anguish and God answered her prayer. Amen. You know, she didn't just pray, she did everything. She went joyfully, believed. As in Luke, it says, Mark or Luke, it says, believe that you receive it and you shall have it. After that day, she walked like she had it. She knew. Amen. And God met, he filled her emptiness. Amen. Hallelujah. So, you know, I remember there was times where we were so empty about certain, but God filled that.
Yes.
And there's joy that overflows.
Amen.
There's a praise break, as we do sometimes. Praise break. Hallelujah. The way it's exhibited in African-American church, I actually like, you know. I'm not there yet. That's why I married African-American. I'm hoping Faith would get some of that. God is so good, but you know what? She didn't just pray because it's easy to move on. As she fulfilled, her husband said, let's take back what you brought. You know, she said, no, I'll wait. I'm going to give God when it's ready, season full. He wasn't weaned yet. She said, you go. This was between me and my God. Anyways, he had nothing to do with it. But you know what? She went. What a woman of God. You know, it would have been tempting, that cute Samuel, to say, you know, Eli, what do you think? Let's use wisdom here. I mean, what about 2 months out of the year? until he's grown up. 2 months, you know, it would be good, no hard on you, you know. She could have said that, but no, she fulfilled her vow.
Amen.
She fulfilled her vow. Hannah, you know what, today's focus of Hannah is her fulfilling her vow.
Amen.
Her coming to the point, let me give you what is due to your name.
Amen.
Let me give you back what she gave me.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let me, hallelujah, acknowledge you for taking away my reproach.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Taking away my emptiness.
Amen.
Let me acknowledge you.
Amen.
Let me pay you the respect that is due to your name.
Amen.
The one that you took my sadness, my sorrow.
Yes.
And you made me mend other people's life.
Yes.
You gave me a vision out of my brokenness.
Amen.
I come to vow and acknowledge you. When I was sick, I cried upon you. And you encouraged me, you comforted me, and I come. It's about coming, acknowledging, let me give you, you know. Or if she was a foolish woman, she would have like maybe give him a 10%, give him a leg or a hand. She brought the entire Samuel, not only Samuel, 3 bulls. But she was just everything, 3 bulls. I mean, what day was she, Nomsi? They took my kid, why I better give them a bull? She went above and beyond.
Yes.
Talk about going above and beyond.
Amen.
To praise him. Not with her effort. She fulfilled her vow.
Amen.
Amen. I praise God. And she inspires me to go above and beyond.
Amen.
This is a side point, but let me tell you, it came to me, the story. During the 90s, it was so hard to get out of Ethiopia. Addis Ababa, I was in Addis Ababa to get out. And nobody would give you a visa. And I remember I had an aunt, Mama Sarah, she always makes me every time I go to embassy, she makes me vow to give gentle talal for all angels. I owe a lot of angels, a lot of salam. I owe them. Some of them, you know, when trying to mess with. You know what I'm saying. Yeah. So I owed, okay, she always tells me, you know, she's into that. So I avoided to go to Ethiopia, not because they hate my passport.
Because you're scared.
There were some scary angels. But glory be to God that that is canceled. That is canceled in Jesus Christ. But all we got to do is break out in praise for what he has done. Amen? For what the Lord has done, to break out in praise. Hallelujah. Hannah, well, if you read chapter 2, Hannah, after she fulfilled her vow, woo! What she did was, you know what? She started praising God, and nowhere it's mentioned about the child. She fulfilled her vow. She said, oh, I praise the God. I will rejoice in the God of my salvation. I will rejoice in the God of my salvation. He has exalted my horn. Hallelujah. He has made me smile in front of my enemies. She keeps going and going, and she says he broke the bow of the arrogant, the strong man. She, you know, there is none beside thee. No one is like you, oh God. She said, the rock of my salvation. You know, there is none like you. All these people are mentioning Moses, Hannah. They came to realization, actually, the Spirit was together today. Even during the worship, it was the mighty one has done a great thing. Amen. The Spirit of God does the same thing, right? So, you know, I said, let them preach my sermon. But, you know, but you see, she broke out in this exuberant praise also. Nothing to do with Samuel. But you know what? She came, her problem brought her to the house of God. Her situation brought her. Her maybe for her was a baby. What is a baby to us? What made us run to the house of God?
Yes.
You know what? We come for that. But hallelujah, we got more than we asked. Yes. And, but she paid attention, you know? You know, people need the Lord at the end of every broken dreams. He is an open door.
Yes.
Amen. People need the Lord at the end of broken dreams. He is the open door. Amen. Jesus is the open door. Amen. Jesus is the way, the truth, the life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Jesus that is worshipped and served in this place. Hallelujah. Amen. He is worshipped all over the earth. Hallelujah. Even this morning, many places are calling him Holy King of Kings.
Amen.
He is the open door for every man and woman who run. Hallelujah. After broken dreams, shattered dreams, people let you down. Things we depended on. Shambok ohonabden. Amen. But when we come, he is the open door.
Amen.
For me, this has been, I've been meditating it for myself.
Amen.
How he has been the open door.
Yes.
And he opened the curtain of heaven.
Yes.
Beyond baby, beyond Samuel.
Yes.
He opened the one that spice, that spice. Hallelujah. Forever and over. As it says in chapter John 4. Hallelujah. You know, give me this water. No, the water that I will give you. Well, if you drink it, it will go. It will be welling up at the eternal life.
Amen.
How many of us came for this problem to be taken away? For this problem to be taken away. I just, my shackles, I wanted them broken. But yet, I got more than what I bargained for. Hallelujah. Even this year, a lot of things brought us to the house of God. But we got more than what we bargained for. He opened the curtain of heaven. I mean, he opened the window to show us, look. 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 Hallelujah. Look. Just as he said to Jeremiah, what do you see around? You know? What do you see around? You know, there's an African song. He replied it. You know, new season all around, all around.
Amen.
All around. New revival all around, all around, all around. Fresh anointing all around, all around, all around. Uncommon favor all around, all around, all around. Uncommon glory all around, all around, all around. Uncommon breakthrough all around. Uncommon calling all around. But you can only see the all around if you stand in his faithfulness and say, the mighty one has done a great thing. Holy is his name. Hallelujah. The mighty one has done a great thing. Holy is his name. Hallelujah. If we say that, he opens the curtain. Because after every broken dreams, he is the open door. Hallelujah. And he will open the curtain. He is opening already. You know, I don't know, just the other day, twice came this during worship for me. A vision came to me. I even shared it with Pastor. She was telling me around that, and I said, wait, let me show you. You know, but this is like in a wedding, back home, wedding, the old man with white dress, with white clothes up and down. Yeah. They do in Bilta?
Yes.
I heard in Bilta. You know, they're doing, I see the old ones, mature, they were doing in Bilta for something. It looks like it was, you know, as if you're waiting for a groom in Dawad. Amen. In Bilta, I heard it twice.
Amen.
There is, hallelujah, greater days ahead. Amen. It's from glory to glory. I'm not saying it has not been greater, but there is greater days. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But we can see all around by acknowledging what he has done already. What am I doing? I'm going to do the same thing I'm doing to myself. Stir myself up to look back and say, hallelujah, the mighty one has done a great thing. Holy is his name. Amen. Yeah, I'm coming to close. Then, you know, it's just another man I want to tell you, and is David. David, when he was rested, everything settled down around him. Everything settled. No war. He is now in a palace. You can read it in 2 Samuel chapter 7.
Yes.
He's now in his palace. The ark was brought. It's in a tent. Then he said he desired to fulfill his vow. He desired to build God a house of cedar. And God sent his prophet and said, you know, I have greater plan for you.
Amen.
He said, I brought you out of a shepherd following a sheep. And I made you a leader of a nation.
Yes.
You're happy about this and you want to fulfill your vow. Let me tell you what I have. Your son will do for me. But as for you, your throne, your kingdom is established forever. Amen. I'm telling you, we got more than what we bargained for. Amen. We have gotten our prayer request answered. We have gotten our brokenness met. We have gotten that. But you know what? It's beyond. He comes and say, open the windows of heaven, showing us, you are this, Johannes. You are this. Hallelujah. You are this. You are this. You are this. You know what? That's what he says to us. Amen.
Amen.
I am Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. It's so beautiful to see from that ground.
Yes.
Oh, he has done a great thing.
Amen.
That's the stand you want to stand on.
Amen.
Ebenezer, he has done a great thing. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is so good. Thank you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen.
You know, Moses embraced, he broke out. Moses, he broke out in praise, but if you read the chapter, you will see him also foreseeing in that praise what's going to happen in the future to Canaan's,
Amen.
To those people that are ahead of them. He foresaw it and he sang about that
Amen.
Before they got there. Now they are melting.
Yes.
See, that's what happens when you enter into praise. Hannah, by praising God for what he has given her, she saw. And, you know, she even said over and over, I rejoice in the God of my salvation.
Amen.
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 She wasn't like, I thank you for the baby, even though it's wonderful. Amen. She foresaw. David foresaw his future. He saw Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Establishing his throne forever and ever. And that's why we call him son of David.
Yes.
That's why the root of Jesse. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, this awesome God is our God. He has done a great thing.
Amen.
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 Now, to him who is able to do above all that we ask
Amen.
And think, to him, according to the power that works within us, to him be the glory
Amen.
In the church
Amen.
By Jesus Christ. To all generation. We are the generation of Jesus Christ. We are called to a greater calling. Amen. Hallelujah. We've been enlightened in this place. We lack nothing. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes. To, you know, the fullness of Christ, the understanding. Hallelujah. It's given to us. Amen?
Amen.
And the blessings of Christ, not only the earthly thing that drove us. You know, people say, because you were weak, you came to the house of the Lord. Because you were weak, you know, this, that, that. Yes, it's true. My weakness brought me. But I'm staying for Jesus. I'm staying for Jesus. I'm staying for Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm staying for Jesus. Hallelujah. The mighty one has done a great thing. Holy is his name. You are a partaker of the blessing. Hallelujah. We are a partaker of that blessing. I'm going to ask you to rise up. If this word spoke to you, rise up with me. Hallelujah. On your feet, because the mighty one has done a great thing, and holy is his name. Amen. I'm asking those, hallelujah, who think, hallelujah, hallelujah, now, hallelujah, to him who is able to do, hallelujah, more above, more than what we ask and think for. Hallelujah. To him be the glory according to the power that is within us. That power works within us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Christ. Hallelujah. The cross. Hallelujah. Has become the power of God because we believe. It met our brokenness. It answered us. Hallelujah. He's done a great thing. Yes, we started the journey saying, Nefsei, Nugget Meet, Gesgesi, behind the Gesgesi. Hallelujah. That was the word of the year. Hallelujah. Surely we have experienced strength like never before. We've experienced a strength. I don't know, for me, there is a strength that I experienced I've never experienced before. Yes, behind the Gaskisna. And there has been great days. But through it all, hallelujah, we're still standing tall. Through it all, we're still standing tall. He wipes our tears, hallelujah. He strengthened, hallelujah. He opened the curtain of heaven for us to see the great days ahead. Hallelujah. So it is. Hallelujah. So it is our Thanksgiving season. Hallelujah. If you believe, hallelujah. If you want to do, hallelujah, inventory and write a song like Moses, write a song, break out on praise song like Hannah. If you want to break out like song like David, hallelujah. If I was to outnumber that, he gave me a new song. If you want to say that, hallelujah. Oh, Rabba Kassanda Rabba Sekere Boshia. He has done great things. He has done great things. He has done great things. Oh, bless his holy name. He has done great things. He has done great things. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. One more time. He has done great things. He has done great things. He has done great things. Bless his holy name. Yes, Lord, we bless your name. Cry out to God. We bless your name. Hallelujah. We bless your name. We thank you. We thank you. We bless your name. We bless your name, Lord, for you have done a great thing. Hallelujah. We look back and we see. Oh, Rabba Kanamasetere Nebosia. Oh, Father God, you have done great thing. We have done a great thing by pushing us to the house of God. You have done a great thing. Hallelujah. For hearing our prayer. You have done a great thing for making us cross gloriously. You have done great thing. Oh, Rabba Kasetereb. Oh, Rabba Seketerebodia. We acknowledge you today, Father. We say the mighty one has done a great thing. Holy is his name. Hallelujah. We acknowledge you in this day standing, in this growing. Hallelujah. The mighty one has done a great thing. Holy is his name, Father God. Oh, Rabba Kasetereboshia. In this ground, Father God, we vow to see what's ahead. We vow to see, Father God. But Father, we come to fulfill your vow. This season, we come to fulfill. We have a vow to fulfill. name. We break out in praise.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We tell you to sing it back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise, hallelujah,
amen.
That he deserves, hallelujah,
amen.
That he deserves, hallelujah,
yes.
Hallelujah, donuts, hallelujah,
amen.
Our Thanksgiving season has started, hallelujah,
amen.
So great to you, Susumi Yabara, great to you, Susumi Yabara, my brother, may the Lord continue to bless you,
amen.
Hallelujah,
amen.
We're going to continue to praise the Lord and our fellowship, hallelujah.
Amen.
May the Lord bless all of us.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Glory to God. Yes, absolutely.